Bismillah, al-Ḥamdulillāh, wa salatu wa salam ala Rasulillah wa ala alihi wa ashabihi wa min wala. I just wanted to do a quick reflection. I happened to be out and grabbing a quick coffee and doing some reading this morning. And this is for something I'm going to, inshallah, do perhaps in the next few weeks or month. Is I want to do not just simply a series of talks and lectures, but I want to do something educational for particularly younger Muslims. Although I really am going to encourage the parents to attend this with their kids. And that is, like, how do we build iman? How do we build faith in our generation today, which certainly seems to be struggling in some ways to have or to maintain it, somewhat due to the toxicity of the environment that is quite hostile to maintaining faith in iman. And so there's a beautiful commentary on one of the, I guess you could say, seminal works, which is the Risalah of Ibn Abī Zayd al-Qayrawānī, who is one of the great scholars, not simply of the Malikiyya, but just one of the great scholars of our Ummah, whose book, or rather his work, is pretty small. Simply titled, right, The Message, al-Risalah, in which it goes over some of the important aspects of performing, you know, various acts of worship, like, you know, how to pray, how to fast, how to do ritual purity, those things. But in the introduction to that work, what has become known as the muqaddimah, right, is the muqaddimah of the Risalah of Ibn Abī Zayd al-Qayrawānī. That work has been kind of really universally praised by all major groups of Muslims. You know, the Salafis and the Sufis, you know, really admire it. And so I want to do a piece on it, and there's a really great commentary on it by one of the great Andalusian Maghribi scholars, Sheikh Ahmed al-Qalshani al-Maliki. So anyway, I just wanted to share, given the title of the little title I put here in the video, and that is, in the beginning of his muqaddimah, in the beginning, he writes, just in one line, and I'm just going to share this as a little teaser and to show how powerful and important it is. So he wrote, Alhamdulillah, alladhi ibtadana al-insan bini'mati. So he wrote, he begins his book, he begins his risalah, he begins the book entitled The Message with Alhamdulillah. And that might seem pretty standard, like everybody writes that, right? Who ibtadal al-insana bini'mati. Who what? He began the human being as or through his benevolence, right, as a gift. وَصَوَّرَهُ فِي الْأَرْحَامِ بِحِكْمَتِهِ. And then he fashioned him in the wombs of his mothers as they, right, as he so chose. وَأَبْرَزَهُ إِلَى رَفْبِهِ. And then brought him forth into the gentle embrace and care, or his gentle embrace and care. وَيَسَّرَهُ لَهُ مِنْ رِزْقِهِ. And then made it easy for him, right, to be provided for. And so Sheikh Al-Qalshani, he writes in his explanation, his commentary, in his sharh, he writes, Iftataha al-Shaykh rahimahullah. The Shaykh begins, may Allah have mercy on him, bilhamdulillah. He begins with the statement, right, alhamdulillah. Idh huwa fatih al-kitab illahi al-kareem. For indeed, that is how the Book of Allah opens, meaning that, right, the first verse in Surah al-Fatiha. And of course, this is giving you a hint that these are all Malikiya who do not see the Baslama, who do not see Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. They do not see that as the first ayah of Surah al-Fatiha, but they say Alhamdulillah. Right? And he says, وَخَتِمَتِ دُعَاءِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ فِي جَنَّةِ النَّعِيمِ. And not only is it the beginning of the book that opens the book, though it is not chronologically the first revealed, it is, however, what we consider, right, the opening of the book. But he said it is also the seal. It is the khatimah du'a il-mu'minina fi jannati na'im. It is the seal of the supplication. It is the seal, it is the finality of the du'a of the believers in Allah's paradise, right, in his jannati na'im, in his felicitous paradise. Right, and so he of course is citing the verse that is in Surah Yunus, where Allah says, "Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim." Wa akhiru da'wahum anilhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. And he's in this I think it's around the 9th or the 10th verse of Surah Yunus, the 10th chapter of the Quran, around the 9th or 10th verse. And this, is the dua of the people once they enter into paradise, after they have completed the long journey from being created, born into this life through all of its toils and struggles. And then at the very end of their journey, what is their, tahiyyatuhum salam, right? That their greeting is salam, wa akhiruhum, right? And that at the very end, their statement is Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. All praise belongs to Allah. And so what this shows us is that the statement of Alhamdulillah, the meaning of Alhamdulillah, all praise belongs to Allah, is not simply a kind of tradition or a virtue, right? But it actually goes something much further and deeper than that, and that it is part of reality, right? Part of reality, because it is in the first and the last. It is the opening of the book. It is the last thing that the people entering into paradise, the final thing that seals, that completes their dukhul, that completes their entering into paradise, is that Allah is worthy of all praise. And so we can see from one point of view, it's kind of like Alhamdulillah, right? The praising of Allah is part of the fabric of reality. For we are not praising Him, right? Which is different than shukr. We are praising Him simply because He has already stated so Himself, not for anything that He has done, but simply who Allah is. And so that makes Alhamdulillah an aspect of reality. Right, it's a part of the fabric of reality that Allah is worthy of praise. Then the second part that I talked about is that it is also part of our being, because we come in, he says what? Alhamdulillah. All praise is due to Allah who ibtada'a al-insana bi ni'matihi. Referring to yani khalaqa al-insana. Right, referring that Allah has created the human being, that also initiated. So the Shaykh here, rahimahullah, is choosing not to use the verb khalaqa, and is instead using ibtada'a, which means to originate, for something to begin. And then also the form of ifta'ala, which ibtada'a is built upon in the Arabic, shows how it is something very personal. Right, when we did our Arabic class, we talked about how the form 8 construction, ifta'ala, is often used for something that is taking a general action, which might be in the first so-called bab, right? And then conjugating it in this form makes it something very, very personal. So for instance, we have the verb kashafa, which means to uncover, whereas ikteshafa means to discover for oneself. It's still an uncovering, but it's something that's very personal. So Allah he's emphasizing the fact that Allah did not create the human being indiscriminately or you know, without some kind of talk. رَبَّنَا مَا خَلَقْتَ هَذَا بَاطِلًا. Oh Allah, you have not created this without, empty of purpose. So he's emphasizing this. So the other part about Alhamdulillah here that he wants to show is that it's part of who we are and of course who we ought to be, which are the Ahl Alhamdulillah. We are to be the people who are praising Allah. And it's a way to be, it's a way to exist, it's a way to breathe, it's a way to live. And so that's why he's putting here that it is not only in the beginning of the book, which meaning it's in the beginning of revelation, the beginning of guidance, right? Again, though not chronologically, though in its completed form, it begins when we open the book, right? Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. But then the final results of that Alhamdulillah, right? Once you crack open that book, once you begin to pray, once you begin to establish the prayer in your life, what, you know, how do you begin the prayer? Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. And so, you know, through all the years that we will toil in this life, through all the ups and downs, the joys, the difficulties, the griefs, the sorrows, the time in the grave, the judgment by Allah, the dukhul al-qubur, right, the exiting of the graves, the qiyamah, the standing in front of Him, the judgment by Him, the crossing of the sirat into Jannah, all of that. We will achieve the success, of course, by Allah's ni'mah, but how is that? First, by establishing a feeling of hamd and shukr, especially hamd, a feeling of constantly being somebody that praises Allah and doesn't always look for something to, well, Allah did this, so I praise Him. But if He didn't do that, I wouldn't know. Regardless of whatever Allah does, whether it is pleasing to us or not, and this connects to one of the shuruts, one of the aspects, one of the arkan, one of the pillars of faith, which is we have to accept the qadr of Allah, خَيْرَهُ وَشَرَّهُ, right? We have to accept it's good and it's bad. And so that is where the Alhamdulillah comes in. So that if we are able to live by that and die by that and be raised by that and be judged by that and cross the sirat by that and enter into Jannah by that, then it will be the seal upon that unbelievably long journey of Alhamdulillah. So I just wanted to share that. And the reason why I'm saying that this is such a profound work, I think, for belief is because, yes, okay, everybody needs to learn how to pray and fast and what, but you know, generally those things can be obtained in a fairly short amount of time. And there are plenty of reference books if you happen to forget something small. You can easily go back and review something if you forgot, oh, I forgot. How do you make, how do you do tahara if there's no water and there's only, you know, a rock? Or I'm camping and I'm at a river or a lake, can I use that water? There's plenty of reference books for that. But what we really need to do is to help build and construct a long, lifelong lasting iman that will not only last through this life, but that will continue to last through the time in the grave, and that will last until the day of judgment, so that when we are judged as mu'minun. We are judged as believers. So, inshallah, I really look forward to going through this great work by Ibn Abi Zayd al-Qayrawani. May Allah have mercy on him, one of the great scholars of our Ummah, one of the great teachers of the Quran and of the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and specifically in this edition, which is a really great edition and explanation of the work of Ibn Abi Zayd, inshallah. I look forward to exploring this and hopefully, again, giving our youth the tools of how to navigate and thrive and live a very profound and meaningful life in the situation that Allah Ta'ala has deemed that they live in. So inshallah, I hope this is a interesting little tidbit, and we'll be announcing very shortly when we will be initiating this piece, inshallah. And of course, we ask Allah to bless our beloved guide, Prophet and Master Muhammad, his family and companions and anyone who follows him until the end of time. And let us finish this little session in the way, inshallah, that we will finish as the people of Jannah our journey. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.